I don't need now so far. Fuck, I'm sweating. Okay, take care. Okay. Might see you this summer, guys. Are you playing golf yet? I played twice.
My buddy's called me, wanted me to go sometime this week.
Yeah, that's what I've been doing. Since it's open, I've went to the range 4 times.
I bought a new driver. A new Cobra F8.
Okay.
One at the golf show, one over here. I've gone to the range twice, and I can finally hit my driver straight.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
That's the thing I've been having since I've been playing golf. It's a driver, straight driver. But the rest is my long irons I can't hit. I've been having problem with that since I played golf. Long iron, I can't hit that.
It's getting to within 150 of the green. That's been my problem. I can always, from 150 in, I can get there. I don't have that much of a problem. It's getting there.
Are you with us?
You're not with us.
What? Thanks.
Enough is enough!
Thank you.
Florida. He's got a Florida plate.
Can we please all kneel down? Est-ce que nous pouvons, s'il vous plaît, nous asseoir tous? Il y a tellement de noms. On ne peut pas tous les nommer. Il y a tellement de noms.
I would like to remind everyone, please, not to come at the back. We want everyone in the front. Nobody behind us. I remind again. Je rappelle à tout le monde. Nous ne voulons personne derrière nous, s'il vous plaît. Merci. I will now leave the mic to our leader of our community, Reverend Anthony Bailey.
Wake up. Wake up. I acknowledge that we are on unceded and unsurrendered land of our Algonquin and our Anishinaabe brothers and sisters. My name is Anthony Bailey, and I'm the League Minister of Parkdale United Church. And I have a story to tell, as each of you have a story to tell. It's a story about how we as a human race can survive and thrive if we get rid of the scourge of racism. I want to share with you a few thoughts. Did I hear one of our politicians say that there's no systemic racism in Canada? Did I hear somebody say it's not so bad here, it's not as bad as the United States? Did I hear somebody say all lives matter? Systemic racism is alive and well. Systemic racism is here, and we are going to get rid of it. those things are true, then why are our policies, why are our systems, why are our narratives disadvantaging racialized black people in such disproportionate ways? If those things are not true, if there's no systemic racism, why are people suffering under the scourge of racism? We have to think about our history before we can fully grasp our present. This country has been built on racism. Our Indigenous brothers and sisters can testify, not only back in the day, but now also. You can't tell me there's no systemic racism here. We have to know our history so that we can understand our present. It's not only the Indigenous peoples. Remember our Chinese brothers and sisters came and they built the very railway that we used to get across the country. And when they were finished, they were charged with tax. That contributed millions of dollars to the government's coffers. And you may not know that this very government in 1911, Sir Wilfrid Laurier's government passed an order in council, 1234, that banned black people from coming to Canada. They did not want black people in Canada. Did you know that? When 967 Jewish refugees came to our shores seeking refuge, seeking help, what did the government do? Go away, we don't want you. Over 250 of them ended up in the gas chambers. This is our history. Don't tell me there's no systemic racism. It's in the past and it's still here today. Is a lie. We have perpetuated a lie about race. Many of you may not realize that the notion of race, the invention of race, is a made-up thing. It was made up by the Western philosophers, the chief of which was Immanuel Kant, who said that humanity is at its perfect and highest perfection in the name and the race of the whites. Those are on the bottom. And that hierarchy has been created and it has been believed. It is something invented. Look at your history books. There's a point in time before that humans were understood as people of a particular land, a particular culture, a particular language. There's no one who's got together in the entire world and says, okay, let's sit down and decide who's on top and who's on bottom. Somebody made that up. Some of you may have heard of the Human Genome Project. 10 years was spent by the leading geneticists in the world, 10 years studying 3.3 billion base pairs of human DNA. And guess what they found out? There is no difference in the human genome. Approach in order to deal with this. Policy reviews, equity audits, systemic transformation, anti-black racism training, and that helps, but it won't do enough if everyone does not get on board. Some people have asked me, what do I tell my children? How do I explain racism to my children? And I say, you have to parse that, because it's not the same thing for everybody. What a black family tells their child is not the same thing as a white family tells their child. And if you are not black and suffering at the bottom of this scourge of racism, then you have to first listen. Listen before you tell. Listen. Listen to the pain. Listen to the reality. Listen to the criticism. Listen to the critique. Listen to the truth. And then you will be informed to be able to tell your children that all lives matter. And if all lives, that means no one is shut out. Our lives only matter if black lives matter. opposition to dismantling these systemic institutions of racism is that we have to tell a better story. I want to share with you a story that I learned when I lived and worked in Kenya. It's a powerful story. It's a story about a man named Madupe. And Madupe lived among the people, and they would garden, and they would raise their crops, and they would keep an eye on the rivers that sometimes overflowed, and they built a dam. After a little while, Madupe decided that he wanted to retreat to the highest part of that place. And he went up and he built a house up on the top of the mountain. And he lived there. And he had a good relationship with the people. They would come up and seek his wisdom from time to time. They loved each other. And one day, the people were in their village. And they looked up and they saw Madupe's hut on fire. And they were absolutely shocked and terrified, and they said, Madupe is in trouble. We love him. He loves us. We need to go and help. And every man, woman, and child, even those who were lame, they were all taken up. Everybody went up to see how Madupe was doing. And the reason that he did that is because he saw down the river that the dam had broken, and the waters were rushing down. It was going to kill all of them. And because they loved Madupe, and Madupe loved them, they were saved. Love is going to save us.
Deux
communauté qui ont amplement participé à ce que cette marche aujourd'hui ait lieu. I would like at this moment call on stage two incredible leaders of our community who have been supporting this initiative. I call on Gwen Madiba, president of Equal Chance. My name, I would like to acknowledge that we are standing on unceded Algonquin territory of the Anishinaabe. This land does not belong to us, and I'm thankful to be here. I'm honored to stand here with my ancestors, those who have come before us and fought for our rights and freedom, including our right to breathe. For the first time in my life, I feel okay, not completely safe, but okay to speak up, to speak out, to denounce racism and demand change. Change in the systems that have oppressed many of us, decades after decades, years after years, days after days. Systems which have been normalized so much so that our demands to dismantle them and our push for equality have often been perceived by those who push back against equality as capricious ideas. That's maybe because they never heard of a young black man whom life was cut short when racist men beat him, leaving him bleeding to death in the arms of his helpless brother.
The cops are right over there.
That's maybe because they never heard of the black woman who had to take an 11-hour bus to New York as the only black employee at the time while she watched her colleague being granted a one-hour flight to New York right here in Canada. Maybe they never heard of the black woman who was paid thousands of dollars less than the white employee that she was supervising. Or the black women who were forced to change their hair or else they don't get the job. Maybe they never heard about the black man who was fired after he rightfully and respectfully demanded for a raise. Or the black man, Eli, who while volunteering to offer free meals to people right here in Ottawa, was later referred to as the N-word by the person he was helping. Perhaps we should tell him about the 7-year-old girl who was beat up at school by an 8-year-old boy who stated that she could not play with him because she's black. Some people are refusing to acknowledge the many reports and statistics, including that of the Ontario Human Rights Commission, which concluded that black people are more likely to be injured or killed by police officers in certain cities in Canada. And I would say in Canada. We live in a world in which our blackness is being weaponized against us. Don't believe us? Ask the Canadian woman who, as Trevor Noah noted, blatantly knew how to use the power of her whiteness to threaten the life of a man in his blackness. This woman whose name I refuse to pronounce is a product of Canada. Canada, home of diversity and multiculturalism. But see, diversity without inclusion is like policy without implementation. Multiple studies won't surprise us black folks here. Skilled black people in Canada still struggle in the labor market, facing substantially higher levels of unemployment and lower wages than non-black people. Yeah. Shame.
Shame!
How many more studies do we need to acknowledge these facts and take action? Money should be spent to support our communities, as requested many times by the Federation of Black Canadians. Black communities across Canada should not be left out of conversations that concern them. Our voices must be heard and our expertise must be included to ensure that proper intersectional race and gender-based analysis is applied to the development of programs, services, policies, and legislation. Now, we all know that even in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic, black people are facing the persistent pandemic that is anti-black racism. Although for years, we have the reign of racism, discrimination and abuse flow down the umbrella of our resilience. Today we stand strongly and fearlessly to say, enough!
Enough!
Dear allies, understand that we can't preach unity without equality. And that no one can consider themselves free when one of us is oppressed. Do your part.
Amen.
Don't just stand here. Do something. Don't let this movement pass. Continue to support black businesses, black creators, black leaders, black organizations. Samia said this is not just a hashtag moment. This is real life for us. Every day, all day. And now, I call upon our government and all parties to not just hear us, but to listen. And beyond listening, to take concrete steps to implement the recommendation of various community leaders and organizations. The United Nations Working Report of People of African Descent in Canada presented several call for action and recommendations that have not yet been fully implemented. We can do and should do better because it's simply the right thing to do. Tous nos alliés, à tous nos amis, à toutes les personnes qui sont ici, on vous dit merci. Et on tient à souligner que la raison pour laquelle nous sommes ici, c'est parce que une jeune fille noire s'est levée. Le changement commence par la jeunesse. Appuyons la jeunesse, encourageons la jeunesse. Quand ils se trompent, redressons-les avec amour. Je remercie No Peace Until Justice. Je remercie ces jeunes filles et je vous remercie vous tous parce qu'aujourd'hui vous faites partie de l'histoire. Ottawa, on a marqué l'histoire. Mais pour que l'histoire du racisme cesse, il faut qu'on marche ensemble.
We stand in front of you with the conviction gifted by our ancestors for change. We've exchanged our hopes for demands for our governing bodies to finally listen to us. Listen to the cries of my black kings and my black queens, or else.
Yes, Mom.
Or else we will keep suffering. Generation after generation to come from post-traumatic stress. Or else we will be paid less to do more even when we are more qualified. Or else we will think that the only interactions we are meant to have with the police are ones of trauma. Or else we will continue to live in fear, wondering if our black child is next. I am angry at the system that continues to oppress our black skin. I'm
somebody
angry.
Come and get this girl. Police,
it's 2020.
Police.
A system that was created to form against us. A system that is based off of us versus them. Instead of focusing on the fact that we both have breath and we both have blood that is red. I am mad at the video I saw on June 2nd that happened in Edmonton. Our brother Jean-Claude, he's alive to tell this story with his wife and his five children, unlike our brother George Floyd, whose daughter now lives in a world without her father, whose father has changed our world.
Enough is enough.
Rest in power, for you have changed our world as we know it. Rest in power. Rest in power, knowing white people are now forced to look at themselves in the mirror and ask the question, am I helping or am I harming the black experience moving forward? Our city officials finally call us to sit down and create long-term systemic change, because that's what it's really about. She said it, it's not an IG moment. This is about policy change, long-term systemic change that we have been asking for quietly. No more! Is larger than any one person. This is a collective assignment. Homework. This will take us, youth leaders and elders, sitting down regularly with our political leaders to ensure voices of color and specifically black voices are heard, not tokenized. About Sandra Bland. Justice for Abdur-Rahim. Justice for Regis. I'm mad at the system that was formed against us. I'm mad. Today is a new day in which nobody can unsee. Let me say this again. Today is a new day. Nobody can unsee, unfeel, or drown the noise of senseless murder any longer. Today, you are with us, and we thank you. Just remember one thing. It is very important that you take it very seriously. You need to be a part of the solution. You need to ask yourself how. I know you have people in your life that you can ask how. We are here. And even though it is not our job to re-educate you, we are still here. But you can do it too. It's not up to us only. Remember, it's a collective assignment.
Be a part of the solution. Don't be the problem anymore, white people and allies.
Remember, we are here in peace. Thank you very much.
about the person that have been, the people that have been helping us host and doing the MC today need to be acknowledged. They have worked tirelessly. Yvette, Kahin, they worked so hard. They worked very hard. Again, thank you so much for everything that you've done. Thank you to this team that didn't give up. Thank you. Merci beaucoup, Gwen. J'ai entendu que nos officiels sont ici. Est-ce que vous nous entendez? Je veux que vous nous entendez. I want you to hear us. Are you hearing us? Are you hearing us? We want you to hear us. When is this going to stop? We want the change now. Enough was yesterday. Assez, c'était hier. Assez, je dis bien. C'était hier. Aujourd'hui, on veut le changement. Le changement. Maintenant. 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 Now. Today. Today. We are tired. On est fatigué. On est fatigué. Ne sommes-nous donc pas des êtres humains? Are we not human beings? Tell me. Black life matters. Black lives matter. Black lives matter.
Black lives matter. Black lives matter. Black lives matter. Black lives matter. Black lives matter. Black lives matter.
After this last speech, we'll be working down to the Senate. And I would like to remind everybody, please respect, do your best, social distancing. I would like to let you know also that the person who had the seizure I've been taking care of, and she's now okay. On s'est bien occupé d'elle. Notre équipe s'est occupée d'elle. Merci de votre présence. Je vais laisser la parole maintenant à Monsieur Godlove. Il est également le spokesperson of the Anti-Racism Committee of the African Canadian Association of Ottawa. Please welcome him.
Black lives matter. Black lives matter. Is there racism happening in Canada?
Yes!
What can we do about it?
Nothing!
Can we change it?
Yes!
Yes, we can!
Yes, we can!
Yes, we can!
Yes, we can!
You see? There's a fundamental flaw in the psychological dynamics of certain uneducated people in North America. When he sees a black man, he must attack. But you see, I'm not black by choice. I born black. I just got lucky. It's true. straw was not mine to make, you see? It's a flaw that we intend to rectify through communication and cooperation in community building. Together we can do it. You see, a lot can be achieved if we leave our egos at the door and come inside with a genuine desire to listen, to talk, to discuss in all honesty. I'm here to clear today that I'm black, as you can see, and you have nothing to fear. The only thing you have to fear is the fear of ignorance. I'm human, just like all of you here, who all moved out of Africa, from modern Africa. We all came from Africa. We became a rainbow coalition here in Canada, North America, and the whole world over, on this global space we call Earth. Does a black man, just like a white man, not have hands? Does he not have organs? Does he not have dimensions, affections, passions? So what's so different between us? Is he not born of a loving mother, fed with the same food, hurt by the same weapons, including the weapon of the knee, subject to the same diseases, and healed by the same means? Are we not warmed by the same sun and cooled by the same Canadian winter? Does coronavirus not affect us all? If you prick me, do I not bleed? If you tickle me, do I not laugh? And if you choke me, do I not die? So why do we insist on living this artificial lie about racism? Racism, like Dr. Reverend Bailey said, is a lie, a big lie. If you accept us, the black people, we are going to build a bigger, better, prosperous Canada together. Is that we are in this boat together. If we insist on rocking the boat, we shall sink together. We don't need to create unnecessary storms in these waters because we will sink together. But if we work together, unite our forces, and forge ahead together, we build a better future for our children together. I am therefore calling for unity in the face of adversity. Let's search for solutions of togetherness in this community, which is our university. The fastest way we can achieve success is if we implemented inequality and parity. And I must tell you, brothers and sisters, equality and equity are a lot cheaper than the alternative, which is violence, racial violence. So I'm calling everybody, each and every one of you to get here today, to get together. Let's all come together and build this thing together. I'm gonna sing, come together.
To march? Are we ready to march?
Thank you. Can we please get our medic team up here? If you can please make some space for our medics team to go through. Something very important. Donc avant qu'on commence la marche, je vais vous demander quelque chose de très important. And I would ask that we all take a moment of silence, a moment of remembrance, to make us remember why we are here today. A moment of 8 minutes and 46 seconds. And in that moment, I'm gonna ask you to think about all those lives, those black lives that we lost. All those black lives that we did not hear their names. All those black boys and black girls and men and women that face systematic racism. Yes. So please, let's take that moment. 8 minutes and 46 seconds to remember why we are here today. Thank you. minutes and 46 seconds. Thank you. At this time, we are asking for our core team and Black leaders of the community to lead us into our march to end anti-Black racism. Black Lives Matter. So I'm just gonna ask for the crowd to make a way for the core team and the community leaders so that they can lead us into the march. Thank you. Please make a way for the community leaders and the core team to lead us into the march, please.
I'll take one.
Old pirates, yes, they rabbi, sold I to the merchant ships. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit.
If you can kindly help us out, and if you see any garbage on the ground, any recycling that needs to be done, please pick it up, help us out, throw it in the garbage. Recycle it, more importantly. Take care of this land. We love you. Can we get the medic to the front stage, please? Everyone clear a path. Point. Medic, front stage, please. Medic, front stage, please. Clear a path, thank you. Thank you. Medic, front stage, please. Clear a path and keep pointing. Thank you. Get the medic to the front stage, please.
behind you.
Stand here.
Okay. I'll go behind you, okay?
Behind. back to that other position that we were. I can move this.